Hi, my name's Matty Warmington. I'm currently at Pataka in Porirua, and we are setting up an exhibition at the moment called Tipo. At the moment we're blacking out the entire gallery, so we've got black colour coat and we're staple gunning and stretching it.
So originally Sandy Rogers had the space booked for a solo show, and yeah, she just thought, well, hold on, why don't we have a group show? And I thought it was a great way of getting a number of people involved, and it happened to be TLC graduates from the mid to late 90s who all had a connection with Robert Franken.
I think it's quite nice when people leave, they'll keep those contacts, because people go their way and then they disappear. And I have sort of like 20 or 90 students which I, over the years, I still have contacts with. It's always been sort of a dream over the years to have a show with some of the students, and here and there, wherever appropriate, to be part of it.
Every few years there might be an exhibition where a couple of us are together, or you know, there's some sort of connection, but we haven't actually exhibited as an entire group before, so this is the first time that this group of friends that came, you know, all the way from 1999 together down all these different paths, and we've joined up to create Before the Night. Different ethnical backgrounds, you know, different artistic backgrounds, we're all so different. I wanted to have an idea or a theme that we could all draw from, draw inspiration from, but not necessarily paint strictly to the letter, the words, te pō. And it's been amazing to see what everybody's come up with that as a basis. Actually, te pō is the night, so there's the two concepts and the two ideas, which are intrinsically linked, of course, but they are quite separate. So te pō traditionally is that place in between te kore, which was the nothingness before there was anything, it was te kore. And then you've got te ao marama, the world of light, which is the world that we live in today. And in between that, there's this huge bridge, which is called the te pō. Various stages of te pō. There's te pō roa, which is the long night. There's te pō nui, the great night. Or uri uri, there's many stages of te pō. But what's actually happened throughout the years is te pō is also linked to the darkness or the night. So there's that concept as well going on.
One of the titles of my work is called The Nacht, and The Nacht actually translated conveniently into te pō. And The Nacht is actually a cloak, an invisible, shapeless cloak that sort of descends upon us, and you need a special form of vehicle to go into it, and most of my other works are actually based on that.
For my work, I have been doing time lapses around the coastline here. I've been shooting still frames and putting them together into a program and creating video out of them. Everything that I'm shooting is pretty much to do with the night or the dawning of the night. So I'm starting with light and I'm going sort of backwards in time to a state of te pō. I think time lapses are unique in the way that they give a sense of almost time travel. In my case, I'm trying to go backwards in time, but it's sort of like creation, you know, the creation stories. And basically, I've decided quite purposefully not to put any people or buildings. There's occasionally some lights in there, but they can be sort of nondescript. They're sort of more like energy or the sparks of life, the start of light. And that's the way I've sort of interpreted things.